Did you ever stop and wonder why God created the world? Why an infinite being would bother himself with feeding, sustaining, protecting, punishing, and rewarding countless billions of finite creatures? What exactly is in it for him? And why would a world with the potential for evil and suffering, instead of a world that desires only goodness and godliness, a world where there is only peace and goodwill among all creatures? Our world, planet Earth, is the least sensitive to God's presence. In all of the spiritual worlds, God's presence is palpable, overt, to one degree or another. On physical Earth, however, that is not usually the case. God's presence is often less than obvious, and sometimes completely hidden. This allows people to choose between good and evil, between the godly and the ungodly. That, say the mystics, is the reason for creation. God wanted the human race to take a world that is indifferent or even hostile to him, a place where he is not welcome, and transform it into a dwelling place for him. A home where he would not only love and appreciate, but also be loved and be appreciated. An abode where he could be revealed in all his glory and interact with all of his children. To accomplish this goal of turning the world into a home for God, mankind would need tools, devices to interface between the divine light and the dark world. So God sent Moses to relay a series of instructions to the people, a set of actions with the power to bridge the divine universe with the physical realm. This event is known as the Revelation at Sinai, and the set of actions related by God as the commandments or laws, mitzvahs in Hebrew. The root of the word mitzvah is the word tzavza, which means joining, uniting, for that is exactly what these actions do. They connect the human being, and through the human being the entire world, with the infinite Creator. Many people think that only the Jews were given mitzvahs, commandments at Sinai, and thus that most cataclysmic event is meaningful to them only in terms of its having spawned the major religions of the earth today. To be certain, the Jews did receive 613 mitzvahs, for they were to be a light unto the nations, leading the human race in its task of remaking the world into a divine abode. But seven of those mitzvahs, indeed seven comprehensive and very fundamental mitzvahs, were actually intended not only for the Jews, but for all of mankind. In fact, throughout the ancient rabbinic literature, these mitzvahs are referred to as the seven laws of the sons of Noah, Noah being the progenitor of the human race following the flood, or simply as the seven Noahide laws. As you will soon see, the seven Noahide laws are rather logical and represent values respected by most people on the planet today. Through the attitudes and behaviors of the Noahide laws, people are at peace with themselves, with others, and with the world around them. They feel fulfilled, content. Nevertheless, the primary reason for living by the Noahide laws is because the Creator of the universe instructed Moses to relay them to the people. That makes them the will of God. And by carrying out God's will, we connect with him. We forge a relationship with him. We interact with him. Let's take a closer look now at these seven laws of Noah. Believe in God. Respect God and praise him. Respect human life. Do not murder. Respect the family. Do not commit adultery. Respect others' properties. Do not steal. Respect courts of truth and justice. Respect all creatures. Do not be cruel to animals. We all have the ability to do good and add light and make this world a better place for all. The Torah, the very word of God, entrusted to the Jewish people. Could God's blueprint for creation exclude over 99% of the world's population?
Дарини полошевис и цоро, подосе да хаиня никрим бри соилом, лейло тейв бро, Ela lasciavasi zora Yeshua Elo, odosi de Nikude von de Sheva Mitzvah Bnei Nea, odosi de Echit werde noch der Rini, was noch gewann Farnaten Teri, schien gewann der Zivui von lasciavasi zora noch Kedem sie gewann, da Havdolo, Benisro, La Amin, Bishle Musa, oder Gerefscher Kedem, Haschola Bose, Und bei mir ist echt verstandig, als ich die Chalokim in Teiro muss dort sein, echt in Jonim, wo sie sein in Benegei zu Bnei Neach, auf Alpi, was Lechiero, stehen sie nicht, auf Kolpon in Begolui, in der Psukim, wo sie Rezach wegen Sheva Mitzvah Bnei Neach. Wo die Hoche Bosei ist und der Birur Bosei ist, zieht da eben das Aini, was er verbunden mit Zechel Anushi. Ist auch damit verstandig, wie bald er das Zechel Anushi hecht von Aben Neach, ist verstandig, dass das so techt zu Emma Scheiche. Wie bald er das, was er hat, Zechel Anushi, ist auch der Fall, wo der Rebischte Rotem beschaffen. Und beloschen haben Mischne, Chowi im Odom von Nivra Bezellen. Und erst dann noch Aviv im Bnei Yisrael in einer besonderen Fall, in einer besonderen Mischne, und das ist der Simon, also hat der Scheich gesagt zu den Bnei Neach, Allah als Kamo und Kamo, eben das ist verbunden mit Sheva Mitzvah Bnei Neach. Und der Fuhn ist echt verstandig, Aber das ist echt Kehlel der Mitzwe von Dinim, am Aspier gewesen, auf andere Bnei Neach. Als sie sollen echt mit Kaim sein, die Sheva Mitzwe Bnei Neach, mit allen Seelen Sifim und Snifim, und bei Koomur, wo das ist echt Nistavu, bis er aus Matten Tere, wo damals die Bottel geworden, die Gseere, war nie am Maschil, Und damals hat der Rebischte, was er gewann, der Mastilot.
Hi, this is Rabbi Cohen from the Holy City of the Holy Land of Jerusalem. Welcome to One People, One World. Thank you.
Rabbi Cohen from New York.
Okay.
And when God gave the Torah to the world, he gave seven laws of Noah to all people.
Hi, shalom. My name is Thomas.
This is Catherine, my wife.
Hi. Yes. Hi.
Where are you guys from? Shalom.
Shalom, we come from Switzerland.
Which part of Switzerland?
From near Zurich, the airport, yeah.
Okay. And what do you think of the purpose of life is? The purpose of creation or the land?
The purpose of life and the purpose of creation is to worship God.
Right, okay. And what do you think of the land of Israel and the people of Israel?
It's a beautiful land, very beautiful.
I wrote a book on the seven laws of Noah called the title Divine Image. And
All right.
You want to just read through the seven laws of Noah and what do you think of how it applies to your life?
Okay, the seven laws of Noah, the first commandment, believe in God, that's what we do.
Right.
We want to honor God in our lives.
Right. Go ahead.
The second one, respect God and praise Him.
Right.
Do not blaspheme His name.
Right?
That's correct. That's what we respect, yes.
Right.
Third, respect human life. Right. Do not murder. I absolutely agree. Four is respect the family. Yes, we respect the families. We have four kids.
Four children.
Four children.
Yeah.
Yes. Then fifth is respect for others' rights and property. Do not steal. This is clear to us.
Number six.
Creation of a judicial
system. Pursue justice.
This is absolutely necessary. We agree. It's necessary to have judicial systems.
Right.
Yes. And number seven, respect all creatures. Yes, all.
Not be cruel to animals. Right.
And yes, we should also respect this seventh command.
Okay. And what do you think of the Torah, the Bible, the Torah, which is the five books of Moses that God gave to Moses on Mount Sinai to be a light for all people, to be a light. These are the seven laws which God
Yes. Gave. Yes, okay, and the Torah is very important. In the Torah you can also read about blessings and curse.
Right.
So we can choose yourself if you are under the blessing of God or under the curse. You also have the Ten Commandments, and it's I think these commandments are still necessary.
Necessary yes. for
all people.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Lily. I am Chinese from Indonesia, living in Switzerland, now in Israel,
okay.
In Jerusalem,
okay.
The holy city.
Okay, now what do you think of the Jewish people and about the laws of God?
I find it is not only for Jewish people, it's for all nations, for all the people, because God created all mankind, and the law is really like a protection also, that we may live with one another and keep the creation.
Right, and the laws of Noah?
Noah, I find it to protect.
These seven laws. The seven laws of Noah, it's really about being kind to other people and being realizing that other people.
I find it it's a must. If everyone would really live and really live in that guidelines, it's like a house has a tower or to protect. So when each one follow the law to make it the life better for one another, for the creation, and also remember him, why he has set the law. I find it.
What do you think the purpose of life is?
The purpose of life is always to glorify Hashem.
Right. And to become more, to realize that his goodness and kindness is for everyone.
Yeah.
Okay.
And for all nations, for all people. Not only, I find it's not only for Jewish people.
And do you feel that what does the Torah and the Jewish people represent to you?
Life. And bring us closer to Hashem.
Right.
To live in the holiness.
And to be more moral and more.
More and more in the life that is, how do you call it, that is sanctified life.
Right. Want to comment anything else about the Israel, about the Israeli people?
I just tell Israel, I'm Israel Kai,
and
the nation will stand with you. I just want to tell Israel, you are not alone. And what all the promises in the Torah, it will be fulfilled. No matter what, I'm Israel Kai.
Juma, my name is Juma.
Juma, you're here in the Old City. Okay.
And
what do you think about the seven laws of Noah?
All religions tell you to do that.
Right, and what do you think? What do you think
and without this, no community can live. Nobody can live without that.
The laws of Noah.
Of course.
Right.
Yeah.
And what do you think of the God? What do you think the purpose of life is?
The purpose of life to make the land beautiful and to help the land. But the opposite way now. Everybody
okay.
is destroying.
Right. Okay. What do you think of the Torah?
The Torah. It's a book from the God given.
Right.
Yeah.
So as a Muslim person.
Yes.
Right. Being a Muslim person, that
yes.
which you are, which your first name is?
Juma. Yes.
Do you feel, as a Muslim person, you could respect these laws?
Of course.
And Christian people could also respect them?
Of course.
And Jewish people, and because it's something universal?
Of course.
And what do you think the world peace? Do you believe that this will bring peace to
of
the...
Of course. If everybody follow these things, nobody will have problem. Everybody will live in peace.
Hi, what's your name?
My name is Khalil.
Khalil, where are you from?
From Jerusalem.
Jerusalem, okay.
All the origin of the religions is from the God.
Right.
The God is for all the people.
Right.
Not for all... For
all people, right.
Yes, this one was my word.
And what do you think of the Torah?
This one from God also.
The Torah is from God.
Yes.
What do you think you're here for as a person? Why do you think God created you, right?
Yes.
What do you think he wants for you?
To do prayers for him all the time, no?
And to be good to another person?
To be good for all the people.
Right. You want to see these are the words of Noah. 1 second, Dakar.
This one, not all. Not all.
Same things.
The same for what it called Jesus Christ. The same.
Right.
The same thing, and for Noah, the same thing, and for Moshe, the same thing, and for Muhammad, all the
right,
same.
Right.
Because the God is God.
Right.
God for all the people, not for one people.
Right. Right. God is for.
The problem is from the people,
right,
not from the religion.
Right. So the problem is, the people have to learn
That this is a message for all people.
Yes, a message for all people.
And it's, you know, it's something that, as a Christian or Muslim,
for all the everyone. This word is not from Noah. He take it from God.
All right.
God told him to say this word.
Okay.
What's your name?
Walter.
Where are you from, Walter?
Walter Stamm.
And this is you?
Ella.
Where are you from?
Ella Stamm.
Elisabeth.
Where are you from?
From Holland.
Which part?
Part of the West.
Okay. And what do you think the purpose of creation is, of the world? Why do you think the Torah is about?
The purpose is that we love God.
Right. And to make the world a better place.
To build the world up.
Right.
For a better place for our children and our grandchildren.
Right. And what do you think the purpose of life is? The purpose of life. Why do you think God put us here on this earth?
To learn something.
And to do what?
To share love.
Okay.
To teach love.
And what do you think? What do you think the purpose of life is? To create more, to find God, and to help each other.
I think everybody should take care of each other. Everybody's supposed to love each other. Everybody's supposed to help to each other.
And the Torah and Israel. What do you think of Israel?
Israel is wonderful, wonderful people. And I'm really impressed with the history. I'm really impressed how people can cooperate together.
This is my first day.
This is your first day ever?
First day ever.
In the land of Israel?
In the land of Israel.
Okay, and where are you from?
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
And your Hebrew name is?
Shmuel Abba. Reb Chaim HaKohen.
Israel, a tiny piece of land smaller than New Jersey, yet consistently the focus of world attention. Who owns this land? And why is it so important? To understand this, we need to talk about the purpose of creation for a minute. The mystics tell us that God created the universe because he wanted the human race to take a world that is indifferent or even hostile to him, a place where he is not welcome, and transform it into a dwelling place for him, a home where he would not only love and appreciate, but also be loved and be appreciated. An abode where he could be revealed in all his glory and interact with all of his children. How would human beings accomplish this task? By means of the mitzvahs, divinely communicated behaviors, tools that serve to interface between the divine light and the dark world. Though all of the human race were given mitzvahs to keep, the bulk of the mitzvahs were given to the Jewish people, who were to serve as a light unto the nations. Enter Israel, a land given to the Jewish people by God and uniquely suited for the fulfillment of the mitzvahs. In numerous places, the Bible records God's promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that he would give the land to their descendants, the Jewish people. In Genesis chapter 15, verses 18 through 21, God clearly defines the boundaries of the land. In Exodus, he tells Moses of his intention to bring the Jews into the land. And in the book of Joshua, we read about how God delivered on that promise. The link between the children of Israel and the land of Israel is thus an essential one. Aside from the fact that the majority of the Jewish people's mitzvahs can be carried out only with elements of the land of Israel, the effects of these mitzvahs in refining and elevating the world are most potent when performed in that place. Call it a docking station of sorts, enabling the playing of the spiritual music, the shining of the transformative light that turns the world into a divine utopia. The connection between the Jewish people and the land of Israel is intrinsic to the divine plan. Without it, creation cannot achieve its purpose. How foolish, then, for anyone to think that the Jewish people could relinquish any part of the land, or that such action could achieve anything, or for that matter, that taking it from them by force could result in anything good. It is to impress upon us the absurdity of such a notion that the Bible opens with the account of creation. It is not to tell the believer something he already knows, that God created the universe, but to impress upon him the implications of that knowledge. Since the world belongs to God, he can give any part of it to whomever he chooses. And that is exactly what he did. He gave Israel to the Jewish people. No amount of expulsion, name-calling, condemnation, delegitimization, or concession can change that. The land, every inch of it, remains the eternal possession of the Jewish people and awaits the time when they will all return and complete the final phases of God's ultimate plan. At that time, the Messiah will restore the house of David, the Holy Temple will be rebuilt, and all of the Jewish people will once again live in Israel. Evil will be eradicated, and all humans will experience an intimate relationship with the infinite Creator.
You better take seven. He taught them the seven.